Liquid, you're still alive.
I won't die.
As long as you still live.
Too bad. It looks like your revolution was a failure.
Just because you've destroyed Metal Gear doesn't mean I am done fighting.
Fighting? What are you really after?
A world where warriors like us are honored as we once were. As we should be.
That was Big Boss's fantasy.
It was his dying wish! When he was young, during the Cold War, the world needed men like us. We were valued then. We were desired. But things, are different now. With all the liars and hypocrites running the world, war isn't what it used to be. We're losing our place in a world that no longer needs us. A world that now spurns our very existence. You should know that as well as I do. After I launch this weapon and get our $1 billion, we'll be able to bring chaos and honor back to this world gone soft. Conflict will breed conflict. New hatreds will arise. Then we'll steadily expand our sphere of influence.
But as long as there are people, there will always be war.
But the problem is balance. Father knew what type of a balance was best.
Is that the only reason?
Isn't it reason enough for warriors such as us?
I don't want that kind of world.
Ha! You lie! So why are you here then? Why do you continue to follow your orders while your superiors betray you? Why did you come here? Well, I'll tell you then. You enjoy all the killing. That's why.
What?
Are you denying it? Haven't you already killed most of my comrades?
That was...
I watched your face when you did it. It was filled with the joy of battle.
You're wrong.
There's a killer inside you. You don't have to deny it. We were created to be that way.
Created?
Les enfants terribles. The terrible children. That's what the project was called. It started in the 1970s. Their plan was to artificially create the most powerful soldier possible. The person that they chose as the model was the man known then as the greatest living soldier in the world.
Big Boss.
But Father was wounded in combat and already in a coma when they brought him in. So they created us from his cells. With a combination of 20th century analog cloning and the Super Baby Method.
Super Baby Method.
They fertilized an egg with one of Father's cells, and then let it divide into 8 clone babies. Then they transferred the clones to someone's uterus, and later intentionally aborted 6 of the fetuses to encourage strong fetal growth. You and I were originally octuplets.
Octuplets?
Yes. The other 6 of our brothers were sacrificed to make us. We were accomplices in murder before the day we were even born. So it was you and I, 2 fertilized eggs with exactly the same DNA. But they weren't finished yet. They used me as a guinea pig to create a phenotype in which all of the dominant genes were expressed to create you. I got all of the recessive genes. You took everything from me before I was even born! But you and I aren't his only children.
What?
The genome soldiers. They too are his progeny, carrying on his genetic legacy. But they're different. They're digital. With the completion of the Human Genome Project, the mysteries of humanity were laid bare. Thanks to Father's DNA, they were able to identify more than 60 soldier genes responsible for everything from strategic thinking to the proverbial killer instinct. Those soldier genes were transplanted into the members of the next generation special forces. That's how they became the genome soldiers. That's right. The genome soldiers that you've been killing are our brothers with the same genes as ours.
genome soldiers.
That's right. They are our brothers, created artificially through the alignment of nucleotides to mimic our father's genes. They too are the product of numerous sacrifices.
Sacrifices?
Human experiments! 1991, the Gulf War. The military secretly injected soldiers with the soldier genes. The Gulf War syndrome that hundreds of thousands of returning soldiers complained about was a side effect of it.
Ha! Everyone knows that the Gulf War syndrome was caused by exposure to depleted uranium used in the anti-tank rounds.
That was just a cover story issued by the Pentagon. First, they tried to say it was post-traumatic stress disorder, then chemical or biological weapons. The poison gas detection units and the anti-sarin injections, they were all just a cover-up of the secret genetic experiments.
So then, the so-called Gulf War babies that have been reported by Gulf War veterans are...
Yes. They too are our brothers and sisters.
So the genome soldiers mean that the experiments were a success?
Success? Don't be a fool! They're a complete failure! We are on the verge of extinction!
What?
Have you ever heard of the asymmetry theory? Nature tends to favor asymmetry. Those species which have gone extinct all show signs of symmetry. The genome soldiers suffer from the same problem. Signs of symmetry. So do I. As do you. That's right. We are all on the verge of death at the genetic level. We don't know when or what type of disease will occur. That's why we need the old man's genetic information.
You want Big Boss's DNA so you can save your family? It's very touching.
In nature, family members don't mate with each other, and yet they help each other to survive. Do you know why? It increases the chance that their genes will be passed on to a new generation. Altruism among blood relatives is a response to natural selection. It's called the selfish gene theory.
You're telling me that your genes are ordering you to save the genome soldiers?
You can't fight your genes. It's fate. All living things are born for the sole purpose of passing on their parents' genes. That's why I'll follow what my genes tell me. And then I'm going to go beyond. In order to break the curse of my heritage. And to do that, first, I will kill you. Look behind you!
Meryl! Is she alive?
I'm not sure. She was alive a few hours ago. Poor girl kept calling your name.
Meryl.
Stupid woman. Falling in love with a man who doesn't even have a name.
I have a name.
No! We have no past, no future, and even if we did, it wouldn't be truly ours. You and I are just copies of our father, Big Boss.
Let Meryl go.
As soon as we've finished our business, we're almost out of time.
You're talking about Fox Dye.
No. It seems now that the Pentagon knows that Metal Gear is destroyed, they've arrived at a decision. They won't even need a BDA. If you want the details, why don't you ask your precious Colonel Campbell.
Colonel, can you hear me?
Yes, I'm listening.
What is the Pentagon trying to do? Colonel, answer me.
The Secretary of Defense has taken over active control of this operation. He's on his way there by AWACS.
What for?
To bomb the place.
What?
Not only that, B-2 bombers just lifted off from Galena Air Force Base. They're carrying B-6113 surface-piercing tactical nuclear bombs.
What? Metal Gear is destroyed. Tell the Secretary of Defense.
The Secretary of Defense heard that Naomi double-crossed us, and he's worried about Fox Dye. Now that there's no more danger of a nuclear strike from Metal Gear, he's going to do whatever's necessary to cover up the truth of what really happened here.
He's going to drop a nuclear bomb to vaporize all the evidence along with anyone who knows anything.
Don't worry, Snake. I'll stop the nuclear strike.
How?
I may only be a figurehead here, but I'm still officially in command of this mission. If I issue an order to delay the strike, it'll confuse the chain of command and at least buy you some time. It'll give you a chance to escape.
But, Colonel, if you do that...
It's okay, Snake. The truth is, Foxhound was already the subject of an undercover investigation. Merrill was transferred to this base just before the terrorist attack as a way of manipulating me.
Those bastards.
I'm sorry. They forced me to cooperate in exchange for her life. You better get out of there, Snake.
Are you sure? It'll be bad for you.
Don't worry. It's the least I can do for you, after all the lies.
Colonel.
I'm ordering them to cancel the bombing run. After that, there's no turning back.
What? What are you doing? What?
Snake!
Mei Ling, what happened to the Colonel?
I don't believe it.
What happened?
Snake, the Colonel!
Roy Campbell has been relieved of duty. This is the Secretary of Defense, Jim Houseman.
Put the Colonel back on.
He's been placed under arrest for leaking top-secret information and for the crime of high treason.
Ridiculous.
Yes, he's a ridiculous man. He truly believed that he was in command of this operation.
You bastard.
There won't be a speck of evidence left. I'm sure the President would want the same thing.
President ordered this?
President is a busy man. I have complete authority here.
How do you plan on explaining a nuclear attack on Alaska to the media?
Don't worry. We've prepared a convincing cover story. We'll simply say that the terrorists exploded a nuclear device.
Smart. You'll be murdering everyone here. The scientists, the Genome Army, everyone.
Donald, the DARPA chief is already dead.
So, you didn't mean to kill the DARPA chief after all?
He was my friend.
And you could care less about what happens to everybody else, huh?
Well, if you give me the optic disc, I might consider saving them.
What are you talking about?
Metal Gear's test data. Donald was supposed to bring it back.
I don't have it.
I see. Oh, well, that's okay. You two are an embarrassment from the 1970s. Our country's dirty little secret. You can't be allowed to live. Well, the bombs will be dropping soon, and you two have a lot of catching up to do. Farewell.
There's no way out for us. Let's finish this before the airstrike. You stole everything from me. Only your death can satisfy me. Only your death can return to me what is rightly mine. She'll make a beautiful sacrifice for our final battle. Do you see this? It will be the time limit for our final battle. This nuclear module is set to detonate at the precise moment of her death. If you win, you might still be able to save her. You could enjoy one brief moment of love before the end. If you cross this line, you fall. At this height, it will kill even you. Have at you, Snake!
You.
Ha 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 ha!
going to blow!
Oh.
You're out of time! You're out of time!
Ow.
Better hurry! It's going to blow!
What's up, Kakarot? Crap. Whiffing. Oh, man.
Have at you, snake.
Ow. Oh crap.
Wrong, snake.
I can't get hit another time.
imagine, Snake.
Oh, that was not good. I shouldn't have fallen off. We got this. Ow. No, so close.
Out of time.
Oh. Almost had him.
Have at you, Snake.
All right. Oh, man. Yo, I moved out of the way.
Snake.
Oh, that was not good.
Wrong, Snake. What's wrong, Snake? You're out of time.
Ah, come on, man. Don't do that.
Better hurry. It's going to blow.
Missed opportunity. Ah, oh, that shoulder charge. Got me.
Snake.
Come on, Liquid. Come on, Liquid. Oh, come on, we're this close. Oh, you got me with the roundhouse kick. We did so good. We still die. Awesome. Oh, come on. Can't take those shots.
What's wrong, Snake?
Oh my goodness, can't hit a kick now. Yeah. Come on, Liquid. Oh, that's just unfortunate. Dang it. Woo. No!
Snake. Snake! Better hurry! It's going to blow!
God, man. Whoa, I thought I avoided that.
What's wrong, Snake? Better hurry. It's
oh my goodness, man. That was foolish. Oh, come on, man. Can't take any more.
What's wrong, Snake?
That was bad.
Nice shot.
That was just unfortunate.
It's going to blow. You're out of time.
Oh. Oh, these boss rages, boss fights, man. Overzealous. Very fortunate, didn't take damage.
What's wrong, Snake?
Oh. Oh. Don't waste too much time. No! Yes! 32 seconds.
You? Snake! Oh, you're alive! Thank God!
Meryl. Meryl, are you okay?
Are you okay? Is that all you can say?
Meryl, it must have been terrible.
Oh, it wasn't that bad. I didn't give in to the torture.
Torture?
And things even worse than that. I was fighting too. Just like you.
You're a strong woman.
Fighting them made me feel closer to you. I felt like you were there with me. It gave me the strength to go on. But I was scared.
I'm sorry.
Don't say that. But it made me realize something. During all the pain and shame, there was one thing I was sure of. A single hope that I held on to. And that hope kept me alive. Snake, I wanted to see you again.
Meryl. That's my codec.
Snake, it's me.
Otacon, good news. Meryl's okay.
All right. You saved her, man. Good job.
I got some bad news, too. We're about to be bombed.
Oh, boy. I guess we're considered expendable.
Is there a way out of here?
A way out? Yeah. You can take the loading tunnel to the surface. There's a parking garage right next to you. The tunnel leads from there to the surface.
The door in front?
No. It's a small entrance to the west of that door.
How about the security?
I just unlocked it. Who do you think you're talking to? I'll take care of security along your escape route, too.
What are you going to do?
Me? I'll stay here.
Are you crazy?
I need a little more time to take care of your escape route.
But...
unlocking the security doors is difficult work. Only I can do it.
Otacon.
Don't worry. I'm staying here. It's my own decision.
Otacon, this is a hardened shelter, but they're going to use a surface-piercing nuclear bomb. It won't hold.
I'm through regretting the past. Life isn't all about loss, you know. Snake, I'm a complete person now. I've found a reason to live.
Good. Don't die on me.
Same to you. Take care of Meryl, okay?
I will.
Okay, I gotta go. I promise I'll do something about your escape route.
Thanks.
Thanks? Well, that sounds nice.
I believe in you.
Thanks, Snake.
Let's get the hell out of here.
What about him? Where's Otacon?
He's fighting right now. With his old self. To be the man he wants to be.
He's fighting for us too?
Yeah. And I don't want it to be in vain.
Me too.
Meryl.
Snake.
Meryl. It started.
I must be heavy.
Looks like we're not gonna have a love scene after all.
Looks that way. Too bad.
Let's get out of here.
Snake, it's freezing outside. You need some clothes.
There's my sneaking suit.
Hurry up. Hurry! Looking good, Snake.